Students, welcome to the lecture video on Wheatstone Bridge. So in the last class, in the last video, we come across the different types of resistance classified based on the measuring methods. It is nothing but the low resistance with the range, the resistance value less than 1 ohm, and medium resistance with the range or resistance value between 1 ohm to 0.1 mega ohm or 100 kilo ohm. And the third one, high resistance, the resistors with the value greater than 100 kilo ohm. So to measure each category of resistance, we have different types of methods of available to measure the resistance. So the Wheatstone Bridge is one of such method to measure the medium resistance. You can ask in the classification also, we started with low resistance, medium and high resistance, but when we go for learning about measuring methods, we are starting with the Wheatstone Bridge. Why? Wheatstone Bridge for measuring the medium resistance. Why we start with the method that is for the medium resistance or the method not for the low resistance? Here, Wheatstone Bridge, though it is suitable for the medium resistance method, since it is of simple form, it is of simple form in its simplest form, it is easy to understand. To give you an introduction about the bridge, this is the suitable circuit. So we'll start with the Wheatstone Bridge, then we'll go for the little modification in the Kelvin Bridge, Wheatstone Bridge, nothing but the Kelvin Bridge, then as per the syllabus, Kelvin Double Bridge, etc. So we'll start with the Wheatstone Bridge. So it is another name for the Wheatstone Bridge is nothing but the resistance bridge. Here, a bridge circuit is nothing but there are two circuits bridged with the third one where the EMF is applied. So when you go through the circuit, you will come to know how the circuits are getting bridged, then why it is called a bridge circuit. So it is invented by Samuel Hunter Christie in the year 1833, which was later popularized by Sir Charles Wheatstone in 1843. Though it is invented by the Samuel Hunter, since because of this wide usage or wide publicity which was given by Sir Charles Wheatstone, it is called as Wheatstone Bridge, that started in the year 1843. So this Wheatstone Bridge is nothing but it composed of two known resistors, one unknown resistor and one variable resistor, connected in the form of a bridge. There are total four resistors connected in the form of a bridge. It is very reliable as it gives the accurate measurement. You can see on the left hand side the bridge circuit. There are two circuits, that is ABD and BCD bridge, or these two connected in parallel is merged with the third one, that is AC, that is where the EMF battery is connected. So as you can see here, there are four arms, that is in two of the arms two known resistances are available. In one of the arm, one variable resistance, and the resistance R3 it is variable, and resistance R4 it is the unknown resistance. Along with the EMF source and the galvanometer, the circuit is constructed. The EMF source is connected across the points A and C. Between A and C, the EMF source is connected, and across B and D, the galvanometer is connected. Between the points B and D, so it is completely called as a bridge circuit. The current that flows through the galvanometer depends on the potential difference across it. The galvanometer is connected between B and D. Whether there is a deflection or not, or whether there is a current flow through the galvanometer or not, that depends on the potential difference between the points B and D. If there is any potential difference, there will be deflection in the galvanometer. That is the basic principle of this Wheatstone bridge. Important one, point to be noted here, the null deflection. It works on the principle of null deflection. That is, the galvanometer will show zero deflection, or you can say zero current flows through the galvanometer when the potential difference between B and D is zero, or the point B and D are maintained at the same potential, then there will not be any current flows through the galvanometer, and accordingly there will not be any deflection in the galvanometer. The unknown resistor here, R4, is determined by comparing it with the known resistors. The R1 and R2 are the known resistance, and R3 is a variable resistance where the value can be adjusted. By adjusting this value of resistance R3, the unknown resistance can be calculated by comparing it with the known resistance. The Wheatstone bridge works, as you have seen, it works on the principle of null deflection. That is, the ratio of their resistances are equal, or there is no current flows through the galvanometer. In normal condition, the bridge remains in the unbalanced condition. That is, the current flow through the galvanometer. What is the meaning of this? The galvanometer is connected between the points B and D. When there is the potential difference between the points B and D, there will be a current flowing through the galvanometer. In a normal condition, when the resistance is not adjusted or when it is not balanced, you can say the bridge remains in the unbalanced condition, or the current flows through the galvanometer. When the zero current passes through the galvanometer, then the bridge is said to be in balanced condition. When there is no current, zero current passes through the galvanometer, that is, the points B and D are at the same potential, and it is maintained at the same potential, the galvanometer current will be zero, or there will be a zero deflection or null deflection. So that time the bridge is said to be a balanced condition. Balanced one is nothing but no deflection, or you can say the points B and D are the same potential. This balancing can be done by adjusting the known resistance R1 and R2 and the variable resistance R3. Because R4 is the unknown resistance, which resistor you are going to measure, what is the value of R4 you are going to measure. For that, you are making use of two known resistance and one variable resistance. By adjusting the values of R1 and R2, and also by varying R3, you can bring the potential of B and D to be the same, so that there will be a null deflection, or there will be a zero current through the galvanometer. So to have the zero current, again and again, I told the potential across, the potential drop across B and D, the voltage at B and D should be the same, so that the potential difference will be zero, so there will not be any current flowing through the galvanometer. To have the zero current through the galvanometer, VB, the voltage across the point B and the voltage across point D should be same. Or you can say VAB should be equal to VAD. So let us consider the current through the arm AB as I2 I1, and through BC it is I3, through AD it is I2, similarly through CD, the in the arm CD, the current through the CD or through the R3 it is I4. So to have the zero current, you should have the drop across B should be equal to drop across D, or in the double subscript notation you can say VAB should be equal to VAD. So what is VAB? The voltage across the resistance R1, you have to calculate the voltage by making use of simple Ohm's law. V is nothing but the product of current into resistance. V is equal to IR. So the current through AB is I1, or the resistance is R1. So I1 R1 gives you the voltage across A and B, or the voltage across R1. Similarly, the voltage at AD, that is the voltage at R4, is nothing but, again the same formula, I into R. I is nothing but I2 here, R is nothing but R4. So the product of I2 and R4 gives you the voltage across A and D. Similarly, the voltage across A and B is I1, R1. So you can write, since VAB is equal to VAD, you can write I1, R1 is equal to I2, R4. The bridge is in the balanced condition. So I1 can be written as, when it is a balanced condition, there will not be any current flowing through the galvanometer or the zero current or zero deflection. Since there is no current entering the terminal B and D, you can say the resistance R1 and R2 are in series along AC, or you can say the resistance R3 and R4 are in series. So across A and C, the above two arms, if you consider ABC, the R1 is connected in series with R2, because there will not be any current flowing through the galvanometer branch. So you can say the two branches, that is R1 and R2, are in series. The voltage across R1 and R2 is E, and also the voltage across R3 and R4 combination is also E. So to find the current, I is equal to V by R. V is nothing but E here. R is nothing but the equivalent resistance across each branch. One of the branch is R1 and R2. The another branch is R3 and R4. So you can say I1 or I3. Since there is R1 and R2 are in series, the current through R1 is equal to the current through R2. So I1 is equal to I3, that is nothing but V by R. R is nothing but here R1 plus R2. So V by R, it is E by R1 plus R2. Similarly, for the below one, for the branches AD and CD or DC, again, the two resistors are connected in series. The voltage across the resistors are nothing but E. So V by R gives you E by R4 plus R3. Since R3 and R4 are in series, the I2 is equal to I4. So whether it is I2 or the I4, it is nothing but E by R4 plus R3, where E is the EMF of the battery. In continuation of this expression, by substituting the value of I1 and I2, so initially we have started with an equation under the balance condition. I1 R1 is equal to I2 R4. Then we calculated the current through the resistors, current through two branches, that is across AC, that is one of the path is ABC, another one is ADC. So that is nothing but, from that you can calculate I1 or the I2. So when you substitute for I1 and I2 in the equation, I1 R1 is equal to I2 R4, you will get I1 is substituted as E by R1 plus R2. Similarly, I2 value substituted as R4 divided by R3 plus R4. So that you will get ER1 divided by R1 plus R2 is equal to ER4 divided by R3 plus R4. So here R1 divided by, so E will get cancelled. So R1 divided by R1 plus R2 is equal to R4 divided by R3 plus R4. So when you do cross multiply, it is R1 into R3 plus R4. And similarly on the right hand side, R4 into R1 plus R2. When you expand, R1 R3 plus R1 R4 is equal to R4 R1 plus R4 and R2. Since R4 is available on both the sides, get cancelled. So we'll get it as R1 R3 is equal to R4 into R2. From this, the unknown resistance R4 can be calculated. So here the equation written R1 and R3 is equal to R4 into R2 is the balance condition of the Wheatstone bridge. So you can write R4 from the balance condition. You can write R4 is equal to the product of R1 and R3 divided by R2. So the ratio of R1 to R2 into R3 gives you the value of R4. In this way, the unknown resistance value is calculated using Wheatstone bridge. We'll continue in the next session about the sensitivity of the bridge or the application, errors and limitation, everything in the next session. Thank you.